चैप्टर सिक्स्थ सेशन ऑफ दिस चैप्टर नंबर 11 एरिया एंड इट्स बाउंड्री. हियर वी विल लर्न हाउ कैन वी फाइंड द पैरामीटर ऑफ गिवन शेप ऑन द स्क्वायर शीट. इट्स फ्रॉम द वर्कबुक पेज नंबर 152 क्वेश्चन नंबर 7. आंसर द फॉलोइंग क्वेश्चन ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ डिफरेंट फिगर्स गिवन बिलो इन द ग्राफ पेपर. सो हियर सी द क्वेश्चन नंबर 1. क्वेश्चन नंबर 1 इज गिवन. What is the perimeter of figure A? What is the perimeter of figure A? So now what we have to do? Just count the squares by the boundary. You will get the perimeter of figure A. So here as a length 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So 5 cm as a length, 1, 2, 3, 4, 4 as a breadth, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 5 again as a length, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 cm as a breadth. So here we can find the perimeter of figure A. That is our formula. Sum of all sides are 4, 5 as a length, 4 as a breadth, 5 as a length, 4 as the breadth, 5 of 4, 9, 5 of 4, 9, 9 of 9, 18 cm are perimeter of figure A. Now see the question number 2. Question number 2 is given. What is the perimeter of figure D? What is the perimeter of figure D? Now same formula you can use. Sum of all sides. First we have to write the perimeter of figure D. Sum of all sides. So here we have to count the boundaries as a square. 1, 2, 3, 4. Second boundary, 1, 2, 3. Third boundary, 1, 2, 3, 4. And next boundary also, 1, 2, 3. So that square covered by the boundary. Now you can add it. 4037. Now we have to find the perimeter of the all given shapes on the square sheet. So figure A, we have to take the figure A. Figure A ka perimeter kya? What is the perimeter of figure A? Perimeter of figure A. So what the formula of perimeter? Sum of all side. Now you have to count as a length. How many square covered by the boundary? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So 5, then plus 1, 2, 3, 4 as a breadth. Again, all boundary, it means length, breadth. And 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4. 5 of 4, 9, 5 of 4, 9, 9 of 9, 18 centimeter. Means figure A having a 18 centimeter as a perimeter. Now figure B having a 1, 2, 3, sum of all sides you can do directly. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 as a length. Then again breadth, 1, 2, 3. Then again length, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5 or 3, 8, 5 or 3, 8. 8 or 8, 16 cm as a perimeter. Now figure B having a 16 cm. Now see the figure number C. Figure C as a perimeter, you can count 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. It means breadth will be 3, same hoti hai. Again, length will be 7. 7 of 3, 10. 7 of 3, 10. 10 of 10, 20 centimeters. The perimeter of figure C. Now figure B. Sum of all sides 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3. It means you have to count the whole square from the length as the breadth from the whole all boundary. So you can get 7, 7, 14 centimeter. Means figure D having the diameter of figure D is 14 centimeter. Now figure E. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 2, 3. It means 6 plus 3. 6 plus 3. 6 or 3, 9. 6 3, 9. 9 or 9, 18 centimeter. So now you can find easily figure E having the 18 centimeter. Now see the question number 3. Question number 3, which two figures have the same perimeter? The diameter of all figures. So here you can see figure A and figure E having the same perimeter. So you can write as the answer in your workbook, figure A and E having the same perimeter. Now see the question number 4. Question number 4, which figure has the highest perimeter? Which figure has the highest perimeter? You can write easily. You can compare easily 18, 16, 18, 14 or 20. It means figure C having a highest perimeter. So now you can write as the answer in your workbook, figure C has the highest perimeter. Now see the question number 5. Which figure has the least perimeter? Now see the question number 6. For question number 6, we have to find the area. What is the area of figure E? What is the area of figure E? Now we have to find the area of all figures from the shape. So figure A, area of figure A. So what is the formula of area of figure A? Figure A as the length and the breadth. Means you have to know how many square covered by the length. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Length is 5. 1, 2, 3, 4. Breadth is 4. It means you have to know 5, 4 is 20. Directly you can count. Area is equal to 5 into 4. 5, 4 is 20 centimeter. So here figure A having an area as a 20 centimeter square. Now you can find area of figure B. Area of figure B. Same formula you can count the area. So 1, 2, 3 as a breadth. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Because 5 is longest side, we can consider as the length. or breadth we can consider as a 3 cm because it's the shortest or smallest side. Now again area is equal to 5 3 the 15 cm square. So figure B having the area as a 15 cm square. Now C, area of figure C, area of figure C is 1, 2, 3 as a breadth, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, length you can say 7. So now you can find easily area is equal to 7 into 3, 7 is 21 cm square. Area C, area of figure C is 21 cm square. Now area of figure, area of figure D. So figure D, 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 as a length. Breadth will be 1, 2, 3. So area is equal to 4 into 3. 4, 3 is 12 cm square. So you can write easily figure D having a 12 cm square as a area. Now see the area of figure E. Area of figure E. That is also length into breadth. What is our length? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. What is our breadth? 1, 2, 3. So area is equal to 6 into 3. 6 meter, 18 centimeter square. So you can write easily. Area of figure E is 18 cm. What is the area of figure E? So figure E having a how many squares covered by this shape of figure you can count? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18. It means the area of this figure is 18. But how can we find? Just count the length 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 1, 2, 3. Breadth 6 into 3. 6 3 is 18 cm square of the area of this figure E. Now see the question number 7. Question number 7 says what is the area of figure A? What is the area of figure A? So figure already we have find the area of all figures. So area of figure A is having 20 cm square. Now see the question number A. Figure has the highest area. So now you can compare the all areas are having 20, 15, 21, 12, 18. So highest means compare the numbers. So 21 is greater number to all. So you can write easily the answer of question 8 is figure C is having the highest area. Now see the question number 9. Which figure has the least, which figure has the least area? You can compare again. We have find already highest number. Now we can find the least number. 20, 15, 21, 12, 18. So figure D is having the least area. So you can write in your workbook figure D having the least area. So now student, I hope you understand well how can we find the perimeter or area both thing from the given shape on the square sheet. If you have any doubt, we will discuss in online session. I will share the PDF also. Thank you. Have a nice day.